lake is so much bigger.
Now look at this thing.
Yeah, it's huge.
This is massive.
Paul, Kawa, and their translator Tomas meet with Francisco Cardillo, a local rancher who has worked the land around Lake Maule for decades.
Hey, ¿qué tal?
Hola.
How are you?
Paul.
Francisco.
Nice to meet you.
We're out here doing an investigation, and this lake maybe have some clues for us. Are you pretty familiar with the lake and the area around here?
¿Tú sabes algo? ¿Te conoces la zona bien?
Sí, mi familia vive de 1929, un poco más abajo.
So did anything strange happen up here on April 20th of 2012?
Sí, yo creo que sí.
He says there's been a lot of UFO sightings in this lake.
A lot of sightings at this lake, too?
Yes.
Can you tell us about these sightings?
Observación iba siempre al cielo y a las luces que a veces aparecían acá en el lago.
Wow. Oh, wow.
A group of 30 people, including him, saw an object, like in a sphere, moving around in the sky, and they did a couple of movements over the lake and then flew away.
You saw that? You saw that personally?
¿Tú lo viste eso personalmente?
Sí, lo vi personalmente porque aparecieron unos cóndores volando. Nos fijamos los cóndores y sobre los cóndores vimos la esfera.
So it's like this whole system, these two lakes. Huh. Francisco, what do you know about the water in Laguna del Maule?
Hay cosas inusuales.
What's going on here?
Las tengo en mi video.
I want to see these. Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Look at that.
La laguna está congelada y estos círculos aparecen.
That's really cool. They're like almost like perfect circles.
Sí.
They're all over.
Sí. Yeah, yeah.
Círculos perfectos.
Right, perfect
yeah,
circle.
Yeah, perfect circles. Yeah. Yeah, that's what they look like.
People don't know what's going on.
Really?
I mean...
Yeah, it's weird. I don't know. We've got reports of objects with strange plumes. We've got a mayor saying he saw a UFO sucking up water out of Lake Colbún. And now we've got frequent sightings and strange circles here at Laguna del Maule. Something strange is going on with this lake. We need to find some answers.
So what's our next move in Chile?
A billion gallons of water disappearing overnight.
I don't see how that's possible.
The interesting thing is that Colbún Lake may not be the key to this at all. It may be, in fact, the source lake, Laguna del Maule.
After an aerial recon, the team discovered that Lake Colbún is fed by another lake higher up the crest of the Andes, Laguna del Maule.
You can actually see it on aerial here. And the witness that our field team got there reports of unusual activity in the air. Also, in the winter, they're seeing strange circular forms in the ice.
What is going on with these lakes in Chile?
Let's look at water level changes. Let's look at lakes in the region.
Strange activity, water level, lakes, and Chile. There we go. NASA reports.
What is NASA doing here? Can you pull up this one here? Chilean lake disappears.
The team uncovers a NASA report detailing an investigation into the disappearance of a massive high-altitude Chilean lake.
Is this like our lake? Another lake in Chile disappeared?
2007. No, this is a different lake entirely.
Between March 2007 and May 2007, an entire lake vanishes. So we've got the mayor seeing a UFO over Lake Colbún, sucking up 2 billion gallons of water. We've got a rancher seeing a UFO over Laguna del Maule, and strange circles on the surface. Entire lakes are disappearing. Paul and Kawa have got to get on that lake, take a closer look, and see what they can find.
All right.
What's up, guys?
How you doing?
Paul and Kawa prepare to execute a full-scale investigation of Laguna del Maule. They are joined by an aquatic survey team armed with rigid inflatable boats and thermal imaging technology.
So look, remember, the most important thing is we're just looking for anything unusual, especially gases, rock formations, weird water movement. As soon as anybody spots that, we're stopping.
Divers here, when we find something, we are going to send you guys in to kind of take that look.
Right.
Great.
Let's go, man.
High-altitude diving requires specialized equipment and an acclimation period of up to 36 hours. So the team has engaged local master divers, Pedro Niada and Alejandro Sosa.
They're there are a lot of things that could go wrong with a dive like this. If we are at very high altitude, that changes the oxygen mix, it changes your equipment. It's an unknown bottom, so we're bringing in some experts who really know what they're doing up here.
All right, we're all set, guys. You can take off. Let's get to it.
All right.
We want to go to that end of the lake. If we can get to that end, that'd be great.
Utilizing a grid pattern, each team will explore one-third of the 20-square-mile lake.
This lake is massive. Kyle, are you seeing anything yet?
I don't really see anything yet. I'm keeping an eye on this monitor, and we're just gradually getting deeper and deeper. But it's pretty gradual. There's not like a big drop-off.
Right.
We have tech that will help us visualize what we can't see. These scanners will tell us if there's any significant changes to the topography of this lake floor. Really, anything out of the ordinary down below that we can't see ourselves.
Are we shallow again, Kawa?
We quickly came back up to about, we're about 11 meters right now.
All right. Yeah, because you can start to see some vegetation here growing from the bottom.
And in that vegetation, there's definitely some thermal readings on this monitor.
Yeah, what's the water temp here?
Yeah, 10, 11 Celsius.
Yeah, 40, 44 degrees.
I saw some bubbles too.
There are bubbles rising right here.
We have a bunch of strange things happening all in one spot on this lake. The temperature change seems very extreme, and I have no idea where these bubbles are coming from.
Try and anchor over it.
Let's get this set up then. Yeah, this thing's ready.
The dive team prepares to explore this area of the lake in search of what could be causing this anomalous activity.
Remember, we're on comms, so you can talk to me and just tell me everything you see.
All right, I think we're ready to launch. I copy you.
I'm going down.
How's the visibility? Can you see?
Yeah, I have around 3-4 meters.
Copy that. Can you see the bottom?
I'm at the top of the seaweed.
The dive team reaches the bottom of the lake at a depth of just over 36 feet.
The bubbles are coming out from the lake floor.
So you're saying the bubbles are coming from under the seaweed?
Yes.
Just describe it if you can, Alex.
I'm detecting. I'm detecting something here.
What do you got, Alex?
That's your instrument.
Can you bring it up?
Yeah.
Whoa, what is that? Whoa.
You got it?
Yeah, I got it. Jesus.
I mean, it's full of water still.
It's full of water. What is that? Was this buried in the sediment?
In the sediment in between the seaweeds, some of the bubbles came in.
Some of them were.
And the bubbles coming out of the sand, too.
Got it. I mean, have you ever bumped into anything like this before?
No, never.
Okay.
We've got circuit boards. I mean, this is obviously of human origin.
Well, we should get some pictures, maybe some measurements of this thing, just so we know what we got. It just keeps getting weirder and weirder. First, we've got one huge lake losing a massive volume of water. We've got strange bubbles in this lake, and now some foreign objects, some piece of technology embedded in the bottom.
So I'm gonna give this, I'm gonna send this back down with the divers.
Yeah, somebody's doing something up here. The question is what and why?